Okay, so I alluded to this before. Cookies are sent in HTTP headers. So when a server in an HTTP response wants to give you a cookie, wants to assign a cookie to your browser, it uses a header that looks something like this. The header name is set-cookie. Like all headers, it's followed by colon and then the space, and then the value of the header. And in this particular case, you say name equals value. There are some other parameters you can have on the cookie that we'll discuss later, but basically they use the set cookie header to set cookie named user ID to this value. And remember, this is the value, and this is the name, and the value can be, you know, up to 4K. Honestly, I don't know if there's a limit to how big the name can be. Generally, this is very, very short. If the server wants to send multiple cookies, it can do so by using multiple set cookie headers. There's no restriction that says headers have to be unique. A server can send as many cookies as it wants. It's up to the browser to decide whether or not to store them. Remember, I said about 20 is the max, so try to keep it under there. Now, this is in the response. Now, in future requests, the browser sends its own header. That this is the name of the header. And remember, this is also the name of the header over here, set cookie. And then the value of the header, in this case, is user ID equals 12345. Again, we have the name of the cookie and the value of the cookie. If we were to make this request match what these two cookies were, when the browser sends multiple cookies, it looks something like this. User ID equals 12345, semicolon, which separates each cookie from each other, and then any other cookies. So the browser sends one cookie header with all of your cookies in it. The semicolon is important, and you may be wondering, well, what if I want to put a semicolon in my cookie value? And the short answer is, don't. And if you really want to, encode the cookie value. You know, this can be whatever you want. The browser doesn't care. So you can Base64 it, you can encrypt it, you can Rot13 it, you can do whatever you want here. But make sure you escape those semicolons so you don't goof up the incoming cookie header. Some frameworks will do this for you. We are going to be operating at a lower level, so that's something you'll want to think about.